Hey and welcome back to Divinity Origin Sin 2 Definite Edition. We ended the last time talking to the knight and gaining some weapons from him, and Apo talked to some kids and killed some guys. We also talked to this new Sir Laura. Talked about something, the Great Acorn. We'd still have to find out what that does really. Okay, let's check these boxes for some content. We just loot everything. Let's go where we're not supposed to go. Maybe it has more damage. Yeah, a lot more damage. New weapon is great. Yes, the Brachus weapon. Speed of Brachus Rex. It's pretty good. So okay. Okay. Go and see this. Now there's an area up here that we can go. Maybe we can go there later. I still don't have the teleportation spell. Okay, let's get closer. Need to clear the area a bit. Cleanse the poison. Melted the dwarf. Okay, I'm gonna split the group like this. I'm gonna put Loshi over here. If I need to go here. And the what was that all about? What's going on? Okay, we stand in, so that's good. And crits. This one. Magic armor or physical? Okay. Knock them both down. Nice. Can't reach that guy. Thank you. got that. Okay. Doing pretty good there. Put ice on you. Let's close him down a bit. Oh yeah, it's frozen actually. Okay, let's use this bolt on him. Probably stun him. Immune to poison damage. I didn't know that's the poison damage. Whose turn it is it? And then come it. Okay, we got one. Easy kill. Okay, and let's knock him out down. Okay. Wow. The game stopped there for a bit. Out of this and okay. Burning right now. Still have encourage on everybody. So it's gonna end the turn now. Stun again. And he's almost dead. One more to go, and then it's finished. Remove all the fire. And a little bit of magic. We go kill them all, and then we just use this to heal everybody. Nice, very nice. Okay, add an eyeball, and where's the other one? Yeah, he's like over here. Shirt and resurrection scroll. Nice. Okay, I'm gonna divide these items between everybody. It's gonna give my other tank pants. Okay, and this is actually a better weapon than I got. The better crit resistance on this level actually. Yep, okay. Must be something more here. Nothing here. What? need that teleport thing. Need to kill those crocodilians to get that glove. Teleportation or buy Losha the teleportation spell. She already has, so pretty good ones. Poison bottle, poison fist pie. Isn't that looking at this? Yeah, I did. Okay, what else can we do here? We need to get those two chests. I'd love to get them. Probably good items there. Okay. We got good experience for this, and I think we get things from there.
Ah, my friend, what do you need?
Take my leave.
The frogs are gone. The children shall be safer. I see the good in you. I see all of you.
Okay.
Go find a little one to bother.
I am glad to see you. You feel
yes. Please ask.
Okay, I need to find a arrow turrets. Maybe we should like talk to the dog.
Oh, the old dog looks up at you but doesn't lift his graying head from his paws. He heaves a heavy sigh.
I'm buddy. It's no use anyway. You're nice.
Keep talking.
Emmy would have loved you. She was my mate for the last 55 years. The Magisters, they took her. Emmy was always the smart one. I guess that's why they took her and not me. Hey, let me show you something. Oh, hey, hey, I think I love you. Key? What key? Oh, the key. The Magister who took Emmy dropped it when he was walking away. Did someone say Emmy? Oh, Emmy. If you find out where it leads, if you see Emmy, tell her I miss her, not too far from here, that she was taken by a guy in a white robe who smelled horrible, like lots and lots and lots and lots and lots and lots of dogs, and also a little like the dragon in the big castle just there. I'm so worried about her.
Okay. We have a mission with finding Emmy, and I think this is the dream where it smells like orange.
Just as you're about to address the lizard, the Red Prince bars you with an outstretched arm.
This man is a dreamer. As you know, I need a word with him. You may wait here while I speak.
Very well. Tell him he has your permission.
Permission indeed.
He bids the dreamer stand up and pay attention, which he does in a groveling and awkward manner. The dreamer then chews and swallows a handful of Drudene leaves before slipping into a trance-like state. He falls asleep. To your surprise, the Red Prince lies down and follows suit. After about half an hour, they wake up and begin to discuss what they saw in their dreams. The Red Prince pinches the bridge of his nose in apparent irritation before turning his back on the jabbering dreamer. You receive a withering glance.
A deserved bit of sarcasm, I suppose. But though this stingtail fellow may be a less than stellar specimen in the firmament of dreamers, the dreams themselves prove to be quite elucidating. Turns out I'm being hunted by an enemy I didn't know actually existed. The myth-shrouded House of Shadow. The dreamers, though, they're on my side. And they've visions of me on the throne. That's because you haven't seen that other world in all its glory. It is majestic, fit for a prince. Oh, I was born with the promise of an empire, and that promise will be kept. But to keep it, I must find a second dreamer, a greater one, a more experienced traveler of the dream world. Bahari is her name, and she resides in the swamplands east of the fort. So, let us make our escape and venture there post-haste.
I could tell you all about swamp dreamers too if I chewed that much Dudenay.
Oh, do hold your prickly tongue.
Huh? What? But I was... It was... Please, tell me. Tell me. Why did you wake me? I was so close. So close. And you smell of burnt hair and barren dreams. But I had the good breeding not to mention it. So close to the dream. It's been so long. You wouldn't understand. Please, please leave me. Not to worry. I haven't slept a wink since your last interruption.
Okay, it's not a... what I need. I find fire in the game quite, you know, bothersome, I would say so much. It's like, it's as harmful as it's for you as it's for the other one, so I don't really like that.
I'm not scared, are ya?
Up here! You're a little light in your pack, ain't you, bud? Who could blame you with the garbage they got for sale around here?
I don't have... A 5% resistance, 5% of... Maybe 5 times of damage is fire damage.
Bleeding dwarves didn't need so much.
don't you take a gander at the goodies I got? Stuff you won't find anywhere else in camp. Procured by special means. Boss don't mind where the gold comes from, as long as he gets his cut. Now, but let's just say folks leave here, but they don't seem to take their effects. Maybe I happen to know where everything ends up. Fend for yourself then, big. Haven't got shank through the gift. Why don't you take a gander at the goodies I got? Boss don't mind where the gold comes from, as long as he gets his cut. Only the finest, you know.
I already bought some stuff for myself, so I don't care. I need to split so everybody has similar amount of armor, so I want 13, 11, 8 and 3, gonna give you these 15 and 5, 11 and 6. A little bit more buffed up right now, so I needed a little bit of that extra.
When another divine arrives, will source change back?
Yeah, I was gonna talk to Amiro.
Leave him be. Don't make me say it again.
Listen, I can help you if you just run.
This clown. You've caught him stealing from my kitchen. Still won't say where he stashed my supplies. Sound like someone you'd let off with a slap on the wrist. Caught him red-handed trying to make off with a second crate after we took the first. Went down like a rent boy when we grabbed him. Easy. Supplies. Crate of food. Citrus in particular. He'll talk, or he'll die quiet.
In Brazil, find the stolen plus increase
fear. All I want is my supplies. Happy to let this clown die in a gutter instead of my kitchen. Bring back my crate, and you got yourself a deal. Ain't been here long, have ya? No one gets to have it all. No one starves anyone else.
He twirls his knife between his fingers.
Divine's gone. This blade is the only god watching over Fulljoy.
Thank you.
She smiles and reaches out as if to touch your arm, but falls back at the last moment.
Sorry. I almost forget sometimes. I can't, can't wait
of course, necromancer,
see what's
so.
Next to be done with this.
Smelled of oranges, so it must be him.
The lizard startles away, his eyes narrowing to furious slits as he realizes it was you who woke him. Suddenly, his expression breaks. He looks utterly defeated.
then. What is it?
Supplies. You mean the orange? I suppose. Though I'd guess Mr. Griff is more upset about the Drudene than the citrus. The Drudene Griff cleverly smuggles into the prison, of course, stuffed inside the oranges. You don't think he'd really be so mad over a little missing fruit, do you? No, it's not the oranges, but the dreams he's after. Same as I, though. I have the right, the responsibility. Drudene, it makes you master of all you see when you sleep. The dreamer is not the play actor. But the playwright, it may be hard for you to understand. My kind, we dream for the greater good. What we see can predict the truth, can even shape the truth. But we need Drudene to do it. Before I was called, before I was brought here, I saw a vision. The void woken, slain, divinity restored. But just as I was about to see how it happened, the Magisters beat out my door. This is my last chance to find out the secret, to find out how to save us all. So you see, I cannot give back the Drudene, not only for myself, but for all of us. My dreams are my gift. They may be our salvation, too. To save a life. Ah, that elven fellow in the cage, I suppose. I knew he'd been suspected, but it all seemed worth it if I could only dream again. Never mind. Take the oranges. The Drudene, that is. I'll find another way.
Be careful when I return it, because I think he really wants to kill us if he returns it. Question, should I try to take on the crocodile?
Leave it, Sam. I won't say it again.
Please, excuse us.
You're talking to me, not him, Sam.
Oh, for the love of Lucien, Balladeer. You're acting like a madman.
Say it again. What you said about my wife. Go on. Piss off. Go on, Sam.
Well, it's the truth, and you know it. She's better off. So what if it was messy? I'd rather puke myself to death 1,000 times than let the Reds get to me. If she were my wife, I'd be happy for her.
A flat smile twitches across.
She never did like you.
The man looks for a moment at the corpse at his feet, then turns back toward the nearly finished coffin, bloodied hammer in hand.
Murder's a big word. No. This here's a bed for someone 1,000 times better than their snake. Rest her soul. Coward will let someone talk about their soulmate like that. Maybe it is murder. Maybe not all killings as bad as arrest, though.
It's an excuse.
He nods at you and turns. He taps hammer to nail and doesn't look up.
I really don't like this guy.
I'll be with you soon.
take your life, so I take your life. Because I have a right. Aha. Armor. We got some stuff here. I should talk to Beast.
Ah, colored like a dog. A very stout, very active dog. I pity you, but Shepra the Ineffable has no patience for weakness. Let your stumpy legs carry you away while they still can. But of course, they'll happily dump your maggot and corpse into the sea when they're through with you. Ha! Of course, fresh. But which is worse, the cure of a disease? A seagull? Ha! Those big vermin wouldn't dare lay their beaks upon me. Dim as they are, they know who has a true power around here. Sorcerers dance while magisters pull the strings. Fools all! Their confusion won't save them from the destruction the void shall wreak upon them. This power
is very informative crap.
But one of us has grown to astounding heights and the other has sunk to depths too humiliating to describe. Pity.
Okay, let's talk to Beast. Okay. Hey Beast, what's up, man?
Come on, you stubborn hunk of garbage.
The dwarf's fingers clamp around a splintered chunk of wood nailed to the skeleton of an old ship. His whole body strains with the effort of wrenching the plank free, to no avail.
Eh? Oh, that. That won't be my first or last roll on a lost boat. Reckon I might have had a harder time of it without your help, though. Bravery on the high seas is rewarded tenfold in the hall, you know. Now, if you'll excuse me, I've got business.
The dwarf spits into each of his calloused palms and rubs them together before placing them both back on the plank and pulling.
That's going to need help.
Must be charmed or something. Go on then, give it a go.
You grab the plank and pull. The rusted nail pops loose, and the plank promptly crumbles to pieces in your hand.
Oh, look at that. Nice of you to finish the job after I loosened her up.
He winks and flips a gold coin toward you. It makes a long, high arc, glinting in the sun, and lands squarely in your hand.
For your trouble. I suppose it were a fool's errand thinking I could make something out of this heap. I couldn't help myself from trying.
He sucks a finger and holds it up to the wind, testing the breeze.
Winds like these, she would have capsized before she reached the break. Well, on to plan B.
He gives you a wry look, as though deciding whether to trust you.
Aye, I was planning to build me a raft and paddle off. I've got business north of here, in a town called Driftwood. Far be it from me to miss an appointment. Why don't we make a deal then? You help me get out of this place, and I'll do the same for you. Happy to trundle around your funeral, lad. I'll be here when you change your mind.
Okay, okay, talk to Beast. Okay, I'm gonna save here because the crocodilians are close by. I'm gonna use I don't have any lockpick in my team. I think I'm just gonna pick an item that gives me bonus lockpicks. I can open the most basics. Okay. Let's do it again. Make it harder to hurt everybody at the same time. Hurts everybody. Ugh. Always with Ifan. I just push the buttons and does nothing. What the hell is this? Got a lot of damage on them right now. And let's keep on hurting this one. Ouch. Okay, that's it. Just a spendable unit. Wow, two hits with a teleportation. Put healing on Ifan. He needs it. Hope I stun him. Stun the LM. Shut up, man. And stun. And petrify. And one left. And then he's, I think he's vulnerable to it, so. Got it. Very nice. Okay, this one doesn't have it. This one is this one. Of course, the guy with the magic armor. Yeah. And we're giving it to... look around. Machila. Sweet, this book. If the rumors are true, Elby reaches an ancient king's battleless from King's Vault, even one on a prison island. If it's anything like Silverglade jails, get your copy easy as carrying it. I'm taking a soldier these days, and that's easy enough for fake. Landed up found a good mark, right? Says he's got a teleport spell. I can feel it's easy enough. Just had to say and escape with him. Far be it, merely it's rinsing their old gold, though. So close, I can almost smell it. The vaults are gonna be outside the prison, if I can believe Barbara, her maps. My golden ticket, I see it behind my lids when I close my eyes. cerebral down intestines. Okay, very good. And knowledge of teachers, some spells, 6 new recipes. Think I'm gonna give this to you. I'm gonna fix the camera again. Ah! My cabinet is stuck. This feels awkward. Why did my camera get like this? Thank you. I accidentally pushed the O button. Okay, let's start. Let's keep on doing the quest. Okay. Should we go down first and do that? Getting the... yeah, I think so. Take a leave.
Easy, hey.
Okay, let's get those chests down there.
I am glad to see you. You fill me with peace.
No, there's nothing. Okay. And we keep on going. I get 3 experience for finding this. Okay, what does that book say? Once our hero was named Muddy. Muddy was a knight. Also, he was a prince. One day he was in the kingdom giving food to hungry people when red monsters with red capes and red eyes grabbed him. They did bad things to the king and queen. The monsters threw the hero Muddy in the prison. He found some friends in a dark cave. and they were nice even though they didn't have to be. And that's how the hero found out that he could still be happy even if people and monsters were not nice, because some people would still be nice anyway. To be continued. Okay. And we find this. Nothing special here.
No grown-ups allowed. Except humans.
Okay, let's bring me back down. Okay, and let's go for the chest over here. Blade and a poison arrow. Let's get back out. I think we found everything in here.
Soldier stands to attention.
Let's go. Don't know where the black cat is. Gavin.
You there. You've just arrived, isn't that right? Are you? It's just, I've a proposition. Something very worth knowing. But it's hardly a group affair. I only need one. In that case, listen up. You must think me mad to approach a stranger, but this camp is full of cowards and I'm running out of time. Fast. Too fast. Way too fast. I've been here a long time. Longer than anyone else. People get taken sometimes. Some folks say they get cured. I
I don't know if I believe it, and I don't want to wait and find out. I have a way out of here. It won't be easy, and I need a partner. Just one. Are you interested? Who wouldn't? Finally someone with a little sense around here. The plan's simple. Completely foolproof. I have a spell that I can use to teleport you right out of here. I can't use it on myself, but with your help, we can both get out of here. There's an artifact that you can use to teleport me out of this place. Then I can use my spell to free you in turn. This item, though, it's in quite an unfortunate location. Well, I certainly got lucky with you, didn't I? The way out's nice and secluded. It starts in a little hidden alcove on the beach.
Give me your map.
I'll show you where to go.
And a hurry!
So, heard any word about the stolen supplies?
Come on, Shortbread, out with it!
Shrine's turned into a memorial, it seems.
You forget my name here.
Mr. Nicochet.
Think you're coin then.
The shrine depicts Lucian the Divine, avatar of the seven gods. You hear a strange sound, like rusted hinges.
He has spoken. Lucian has spoken. The eternal prayer.
And I'm gonna finish first the teleport spell, teleport, and then I'm gonna go back here, so. Gavin. It's just like he's like right here, but is he hiding? Where is he? Oh, never mind. I just run to the area I know where he's gonna be at. Ah, okay.
Put me down to the ledge behind me near the tree stump. I just need to see you clear. Come close to the edge as you can, friend. Simply perfect. Now, teleport me to that mossy rock across the gulch, just by the torch. Almost there. Even the air smells better here above that pit. Thanks for the help, and good luck getting yourself out.
Looks like it's just you and me, Stumpling.
I'm gonna put it on.
Ah, there's no way off. There'd be enough wood in that stump to make a ladder.
Okay. Serene. Keep the poison away and we'll go up.
Everything has a heart.
Supposed to be some stuff here down here.
They're transforming.
Yep. Skeleton. X. I didn't get. God damn it. How about this? I shall kill you. Fire. Let's make another level of this and I'll probably finish the job. Everybody into the water. Kidding me? Okay, there we go. Okay, we have some meat, some want, yeah. And a fish, of course. Where would you be without a fish? Load the corpse and read it. Just that you don't seem to be found some required sleep, brought enough dry bread at last. Me, when all the blows over, I'll be happy to say I survived. Covert group of dumb brutes. Sleep down from my bread. I go smart if I want to eat. Met an old fisherman named Rat. Taught me how to make net. Rat's gone. Dumb brutes took my net. At least the meanest one got took in the night, getting hungry. Always was strong swimmer in waters. Around here are pretty glassy. Can't be much more than a few miles to shore. Can it? Okay. With the stream. Almost destroyed it. Like summon this guy and make him attack it. I have money, but I was good. Okay. It's always so loud when the summoned creature dies. It's always funny to listen to. The grave, and there's a grave over here. She's good at finding stuff, so I think it's memory or intelligence. Seems no one can find it. Can I target an area that I know that is possibly... let's try it. Best experience. good as any. Okay, I remember this area.
Two empires, tooth and claw, humans and lizards, fighting since the dawn of time.
Okay, very nice. God, that's an awesome weapon. Strength and warfare. Wow. Okay, is this better than what you got? No. It's not. Okay, and get a lot of armor, but he's gonna have always the most armor. That's my mission here. Wasn't there something else? I'm getting quite well equipped now, so I think I'm gonna run where the tomb is over here. Then I'm gonna say it good for now. Well, it's been fun. We've been doing a lot of quests, a lot of fighting, a lot of tactics in the fightings, and it's been lovely. Thank you guys for watching, and subscribe and like, of course, and put that like bell thingy, and then you will get notified every time I make a new video. And I'm gonna post daily now, this and BattleTech every day. And soon, I hope, I will probably we'll pre-order the Fallout games. And I'm not gonna talk about it here. And but this is not really good game. I love it. Good story. It's, it keeps you like, you get new stuff to do every time. Funny stories. And talking to pets, all that. Thank you very much, guys, for watching, and